I've not seen one like this yet. That's interesting one. Okay. Let's see basically what this looks like. It's not of a, I don't know what of a size is it. Let's do it again. Okay, that looks like this. How this stuff could happen? It's a technical thing. I don't know. Maybe they cut me from the internet in meanwhile and connected, or you know, they did something. Who the fuck knows what? Let's see what. I see the font changed too, but this is normal. Let's see now. It says here that sorry, we cannot copy your photos to your blog. Interesting. I did not have this kind of case yet. All we do is we do it like this. Then we do it like that, and we do it like this. That makes things easy. Maybe the blogger doesn't like me. Americans worked together with the Borut Pahor, with all these people, Mil and Kuch and so on. Maybe they don't like it. You could not imagine how many problems I had with these people during MK Ultra. There is a swamp in the United States of America. It needs to be dried up. It needs to be cleaned up, this country. This is undeniable. I don't know who is blocking me right now from uploading this to, why I would be blocked from uploading this file to Blogger. I don't see any kind of technical problems that would pose something, anything that would actually that would suggest me that it's okay for this to happen. It never happened to me this stuff before, or maybe once every 10 years or something like that. I don't recall actually that something like this would have happened. Huh? Slovenian president, no? But it did right now, and I'm gonna put this video right below. So I don't know what exactly what exactly it means, but yeah, here. The video is going to be right here. Date and time. I know what happened just right now when I was when I was trying to post this news. Just basically, I had to copy paste this image. I know exactly what happened. Of Borut Pahor. We were inside of this kitchen together with whoever had me. I don't know. It must have been either a state prosecutor, must have been... I don't think it was an ordinary, or maybe it was even a police investigator. I don't know. I don't recall who the person was. But I had a feeling there was not a frequent person that was involved in MKUltra, because if it would be one of those police officers, whatever. But then again, they stated in front of American, in front of Americans. That must be a Google executive, blogger, might be even, I don't know who else was present. During MKUltra, they don't allow you really to go like this, you know. Not if you're in a closed place with people inside, you know. Typically, you know, I would even turn like this. They create a special kind of atmosphere. This is so bitten down, fucked up process, torturous, murderous process that is impossible to explain. However, an individual who seated right here next to me, he stated to a blogger, Google executive, or maybe Central Intelligence Agency executive, it's not necessary that it's a Google blogger, people, employees that surveillance my blog. However, this blog is definitely surveillanced. However, he stated that any letter I type, anything I type, everything is, boy, everything is, they watch as I type stuff. He stated, he asked if he could please do something if I ever identify Borut Pahor. And that little something is exactly what you have seen. I fell at the time when they stated this to whomever they have stated on American side, if he can do something. You know, I identify one in a such a way that because they're reminded of certain things, they reminded because they even misinterpreted and lied about the facts, because they wanted facts as they were to be seen in a completely different light. Those that reminded were those that were in control of the situation, of this case, I should say. And those were Udba people. That was a KGB, no doubt. And so when they stated to me this stuff, I was really, really miserable. I was thinking about, well, I said, you're gonna try to make people as paranoid as much as possible. This is what I melted in my head, right? So if you're gonna do something, because they explained to me they're gonna do something, you can do something, you know, like a sign. A sign was exactly the word they used. I fell under the pressure. I was under the pressure. Sign, that means that, you know, can you do something? Sign, basically. Sign in Yugoslavia was always, everything was about sign, you know, sign. They were never hiding the violence, talking about the Yugoslav Ozna, talking about the Udba. The violence was rampant and everywhere. They prided themselves with the violence. This wasn't something that they would be hiding or secretive about during Yugoslavia. They were not. They did not mind, like, let's say, inside of the school. This was a training, literally a brainwash type of training, brainwash, for you to get used to, basically, being even admitted by the perpetrators that they caused you damage, that they were the one who did something, and so on. Literally with teachers afterwards acting as the judges, simply disregarding it, you know. Yugoslavia had fallen apart, as you know, in 1991. 90, and under different circumstances, I would even say, and that's the way I plan on keeping it. But let me demonstrate you something. Let me demonstrate you whom you tried to intimidate. And then think about if you have any kind of chance here. I'm gonna have to upload this video again. I don't know what kind of military would that be. I'm thinking about, but I don't know what kind of military, but what comes to my mind is something like a kamikaze pilots. It comes to me to mind when it comes to mind. It comes to me, let's see, North Korean military. That doesn't show a whole lot. Yeah, maybe this guy, maybe something like this. Do you know whose website the fuck you're playing with? Do you know where you're being video recorded now about playing with it? This guy right there that is holding a machine gun, whatever he's holding, he doesn't even know why he's holding that machine gun. Maybe he doesn't. Likely, 99% of the people don't know why they hold one. 99% is an extremely, extremely high number. People hold one either because they're part of the system, if they're really good, brainwashed, whatever, they will go and hold one to defend the system. If it's a dictatorial system, it's because the two things: either they don't know what they're defending, or because they are squashing other portion of the population. It always depends on the system. So when you look at that guy, that's not really me. I'm 1,000 times worse than that. I am not gonna say I'm a kamikaze pilot. I was warned about saying stuff like this during MKUltra. But I'm 1,000 times worse than that. And you think you can intimidate me? You think you can? We didn't even get anywhere yet with it. You can pull the signs, you can do whatever you want, but you know, I lost 53 years of my life, and when I say we didn't even get anywhere yet, I just started this game. I think that pretty much explains everything. You don't understand who you fuck with. Actually, you do understand, because you destroyed a lot of people through all kinds of different issues. The problem is time. And you pride yourself, let me explain to you, you are priding yourself with deletion of my life, 53 years. For you, it's a trophy. It's a trophy. For you, it's a trophy. Putin, I fuck this guy. He still doesn't have a family and this and that. Listen, the day is going to come when it's going to all pay. You already paid big time. Soviet Union gone off the picture. Yugoslavia gone off the picture. Listen, you're going to keep fucking with it. The day is going to come when you're going to pay for it all. I don't know whether is it that you fucking hate your people so much, or you want death yourself. But the day is going to come when you're going to pay for it all. Make no mistake about it. That's not a regular website to fuck with.